See? I told you to expect more awesome music in this list. Bought on a whim by my parents thanks to an in-store demo, the original DDR was my first exposure to rhythm games, and quickly became one of the most played games on my PS1. Right up until the dance pad broke, because back in the day, those things were cheaper than a team of 6 Mewtwos. I didn't care though. With no help from anybody, I figured out how to play it on controller instead. And I felt even less bad about it a few years later when I discovered a DDR Extreme 2 machine at my local arcade. I don't even want to think about how much money I pumped into that thing. No joke, I played DDR so much that when I started taking Chunkook Do classes, people twice my size were getting knocked back and commenting on how strong my kicks were. Bayonetta wishes she had these legs. Extreme 2 is another game for another video though. This year, I want to focus on the original because much like Banjo-Tooie, I wouldn't have appreciated it as much without the previous entry, and second, DDR Konomics helped shape a lot of my taste in music. The love I have for fast tempos and electronic beats probably came from both being exposed to and wanting to master these songs. And what a soundtrack this game has! Sure, the tracklist isn't as expansive as some of the later entries, but it's incredibly tight. Whoever was in charge of these games at Konami way back in the day knew exactly what they were doing. Not only do these songs represent a lot of different genres and styles, and not only do they cater to several different levels of skill, but each one naturally lends itself to a completely separate gimmick in terms of play style. Some have really fun lyrics like On the Jazz or Drop the Bomb, some have ridiculously catchy hooks like Afronova Primeval or Hysteria, some introduced really cool mechanics that would get expanded on later in the series like Wild Rush, and some yet are just beautiful and haunting like Healing Vision, Era, or Look to the Sky. Then there are songs like Salamander that just hit you with hook after hook of pure electronic goodness, Higher, which is just feel good and fun to sing along with, and Make a Jam, which I dare you to subtitle this. I will pay money for you to make the attempt. And then there's the dark side of this game. Songs like Trip Machine, which is weird and foreboding and doesn't sound like anything else on the disc. Not to mention it's one of the trickier songs in the whole collection, which makes it stand out even more. But the king in that regard is Paranoia, which you don't even unlock at first. It shows up when it feels like it and just sits there, menacingly. It taunts you with that difficulty rating, motivating you to grind out your skills on other songs so that you may one day be ready for it. And just when you think you've seen the worst, the song has a sequel. It's like it came back from the dead for revenge and is even tougher than before. That's how on point this soundtrack is. The songs themselves have personalities. They feel more like characters than the dancer you choose to represent yourself, and actually, come to think of it, this might be where my affinity for Maid started. Now, hold up! Stop! I know what you're thinking now that I've said that, and I want to set some ground rules for this. Pay attention, because this is very important. Do not send me art of Maid Zuken. I repeat, do not send me art of Maid Zuken. Are we clear on this? Yes? Okay, good. I'm glad we sorted this out. This game sent me on a path. It's shaped my tastes for years to come. And without giving too much away, the fact that I got a taste for this genre so early in my life has farther-reaching effects further down this list. It's one of the greats, and something that I think any video game music buff needs to experience at least once.